everybody, and welcome. It is finally spring here in Paris, and I'm so excited because fall and winter were especially gloomy this year. We got so much rain, and the lack of sunlight was really sort of weighing on me. But now it is still windy and blustery and rainy, but we are getting so much more sunlight and sometimes even a few hours of really warm, sunny weather, and so I'm excited. And it has me thinking about these spring pieces that I'd like to take out of storage and start wearing. And I have the bad habit, especially in the transitional season from winter to spring, of just wearing my winter clothes until it gets too warm to wear them anymore, and I miss out on wearing my warmer or cooler weather but warmer fabric spring clothes, such as garments made in wool or a thicker jersey but in pastel sort of spring colors, which I absolutely adore. And it's a shame because they're too warm to wear in the summertime, and then the colors aren't quite right for the fall. I don't want to wear a pastel yellow in the fall, for example. And so I have picked out 8 outfits today that I would like to wear. So outfits that I enjoy wearing, or that I haven't put together before, or that I aspire to wear more because there are pieces in my wardrobe that I haven't been wearing or haven't reached for very often in the springtime. So some of them are aspirational. And I've planned them for cooler weather, warmer weather, and then also in 3 different contexts. So a professional context for when I go to work, and then going out, so going to a ballet or out to dinner or even a outdoor wedding, for example, and then weekend activities like light walks or going out outside activities. So I hope this interests you, and let's get right to it. It is currently a very blustery spring day, so please forgive the changes in lighting. It has gone from bright and sunny to apocalyptically gray and windy and rainy. So a typical spring day, but there you go. Before we begin, I wanted to give you some context of where I live and what my lifestyle is like, because that definitely influences what I wear. I am originally from the United States, which you can probably tell from my accent, but I have been living and working in France for the past almost 15 years. I've made my life here, I'm a dual citizen, and I live in the suburbs of Paris and I work in the center of Paris. And so that definitely sort of influences my style. I think that the French or Parisian style has definitely influenced how I put together my outfits and come up with the ideas for the garments I want to make, and then also the fabrics that are available to me. And then I also speak French, so I am able to sometimes make French patterns. And the ones that I'll show you today are also available in English, so don't worry. But first, I wanted to talk to you today about the professional outfits that I've put together. There are 3, and these are outfits that I would wear to work, not working from home. Definitely the days when I'm commuting into the office, which I do 3 times a week. And I work in publishing, so I work in an office setting. And because it's in the arts, the dress code is very loose. So it goes from sort of a smart casual to more formal. And I have some colleagues who come in sort of nice blouses or shirts and jeans. And then I have other colleagues who come to work in blazers or suits. And so there's a wide range for creative expression in one's clothes. And I tend to enjoy wearing a little bit more formal clothes. I like dresses and skirts, for example. And so here are the outfits that I have put together for my work context. The first work outfit that I'd like to show you today is this lace top and wool wrap skirt. The wrap skirt is the Silverette Ivy skirt that I made a few years ago in this wool, I think it's a wool blend. Originally, when I made this pattern, I made it in a size 8 because that was the smallest size available in the size range available for this pattern. And it works for my hips, but not for my waist. My waist is a hypothetical size down from that size. And I thought it wouldn't be a big deal because it fit pretty well when I first tried it on, but over the years, I think I made this 3 years ago, I realized I wasn't reaching for it at all, and it was because it was hanging kind of weirdly. Like, it would hang more around my high hips rather than my natural waist at the top, and then the hem wasn't just below the knees, it was in this awkward, not quite midi length, but sort of mid-calf length. And so I didn't really wear it, it looked kind of bulky and sloppy. And so recently I took this out of storage and I really wanted to wear it. It's such a shame, it's such a beautiful spring color, this light blue. And so I modified it by unpicking the back seam and the zipper in the back and re-sewing it up. I think I took out total 3 centimeters from the back seam, so 1.5 centimeters on either side, and then put this zipper back in. And I chose to do it in the back seam because if I were to fiddle with the side seams, that would also change the way it wraps in the front. I'd have to modify the wrap and the wrap pieces, and I didn't want to do that. So the consequence is that the side seams sit a little bit further back than they're supposed to. They don't sit at the exact sides, but I think that's okay. I don't think it's very noticeable. I don't think that anyone would really notice unless I told told them. And that way I was able to take it in, and now it sits correctly at my natural waist at the waistband, and then the hem sits a little bit higher just below my knees, and it just seems like it fits me so much better. And then the top is a guipure lace that was gifted to me in exchange for an article by Minerva, and I will link below the article if you'd like to read all about this project in detail. But basically I made the How to Do Fashion number 00 Denmark top, which is also a free pattern if you sign up for the How to Do Fashion newsletter, which I will link below. And I decided to make it in this guipure lace, or guipure, guipure lace. And the difficulty with this one is that it has two darts in the front and two darts in the back. And rather than sewing seams with this guipure lace, which would be super bulky, I decided to overlap them, so decoupe around the lace pattern and overlap them and then hand sew them down at all the darts and the side seams. And I inserted a zip at the left side seam myself. This is a modification to the pattern, this isn't in the pattern, to help me get in and out of it. And I lined it with a light cotton line to avoid transparency. And this was definitely the most artistic and involved project I've made for a top ever, and so it does feel like I'm wearing a piece of my own art when I'm wearing this one. It's definitely very fiddly. It's white, so I'm always very nervous about getting it stained, and then it is difficult to get in and out of because it's very narrow at the chest, and the zip that I inserted doesn't really help me get it over my shoulders, so it does take some wiggling to get into it, but I really like wearing it. I think for a formal event, it would look really, really nice with this skirt, and I could always wear a white cardigan over it and then put tights underneath the skirt to make it suitable for cooler weather as well. So I really want to try wearing this outfit a few times this spring. The second work outfit is a combination that I typically wear a lot. It is a skirt with a top and a cardigan, and this is something that I wear all the time. It's probably the outfit that I'll be reaching for the most this springtime. And the skirt is the Delia Creates pleated pencil skirt in this slightly stretchy cotton jacquard that I found from Ose Patterns many, many years ago. And I love the detail of the pleat rather than a vent in the back. I think that it's really interesting. It's very comfortable. It's got a little bit of stretch, so it's not restrictive, and it's got a lovely shape, and I just love wearing this one. And I think it's very versatile because it has a little bit of black as well as blue and white in it, so I can wear it with black tights, or I can wear it in the spring without tights and it looks fine, so it's perfect for the spring. And then I'm also wearing it with my Sew Over It silk cami in a white viscose. I made this in a size 8 as well. It's the same issue as with the Ivy skirt. They didn't have a size 6 available at the time. Now there is. So I'll have to try making it again. I ended up modifying this one two ways. I took it in at the shoulders because it was gaping a little bit too much at the neckline, and then I fully lined it with the same viscose fabric as the outside with the fashion fabric, rather than just doing a facing because it would have shown through and I wanted to avoid all transparency. And I love this top. It is still a little bit gapey at the neck, but I think that the drape is still really beautiful and it goes with a lot of my garments. So it is a wardrobe staple for me, especially in the springtime. And then I'm wearing it with a new make that's not quite finished. It is this Muse Patterns Jenna Cardigan that I made in the hip length and with the V-neck variation, which is an expansion pack you can purchase in addition to the cardigan pattern. And I made it in this blue double knit fabric that I've been working with a lot lately. And I haven't put the buttons in yet, but I really love the shape and I like that it hangs at the high hip. They have a version that comes to the waist as well. This is what I'm wearing today. It is the Jenna Cardigan in a pink fabric that I made 5 or 6 years ago that I wear all the time, and it's the V-neck version and it's waist length. I really love this cardigan pattern, and I have a few versions of this one, and it's just really versatile, and I think that it will be perfect with this outfit. The last work outfit that I'm planning to wear this spring is more of an aspirational outfit, but not because I don't like these pieces, but because I haven't figured out how to wear them yet. But I think that together they are perfect. And it is this short sleeve sweater and trouser combination. The trousers are the Tatiana trousers by Just Patterns, and I made them in this Robert Kaufman stretch rayon suiting fabric from Minerva. I think this is an instance of a perfect pairing of fabric and pattern. I think that this fabric looks absolutely gorgeous in this trouser pattern. I think that it holds the pleat well, and then the way it hangs in the straight cut legs is really beautiful, and it's the perfect weight as well. It's a lovely color and drape, and I just love wearing it. And the trousers as well, I like the way I look in them, and I like that they're high-waisted, but I haven't really figured out how to wear them yet. Because they're a little bit loose, I don't want to wear them with tops that are too loose on top, but then also I feel kind of uncomfortable and exposed when I wear more very tight knit tops with these pants. So I think that I found the perfect piece to pair with it, and it is the Knitting for Olive Carly tee that I knit and finished this autumn, and the Knitting for Olive Soft Silk Mohair and Merino in the, I think, soft blue colorway. I haven't been able to wear this yet because I finished it in, I think, November, and it's been too cold so far, but I think it will pair really well with these trousers, and I think it's not too tight and not too loose, and it won't be too hot or too cold. It is perfect for spring, and the color too. I think that they go really well together. The only thing is that I think that I am definitely a little bit, as in a lot, sensitive to the mohair. It itches. But I noticed after wearing it for a day that my skin didn't break out in a rash or anything. So I think it's just discomfort and it's not an allergy. I think someone suggested in the comments of one of my videos to wash it with shampoo or conditioner to kind of calm down the itchiness of the mohair. So I think I'll try that, but I think it's worth it, the slight discomfort. I think that these two will pair really well and I'm really excited to wear them this season. The second category is for going out, so a nice evening dinner or a show or even a party, and I have three outfits to show you today. The first is my Vogue 8379 polka dot wrap dress, and you've seen this before, and it's because it is very versatile. I wear it a lot of the seasons. I wear it in the spring, summer, and fall, and it is just the perfect dress for most occasions. It can go from casual to formal, and I love it. So this is perfect for an afternoon barbecue or a birthday party or even going to work, and I love this dress. So I made this in a slinky cotton jersey, and I modified it by making the sleeves 3/4 length and then taking out the cuff detail. This pattern I think is no longer available, but I think that McCall's or Vogue has released a new pattern to replace it, so I will link that one below. But I love this dress. I especially love the fit of the wrap because I find that a V-neck wrap is really hard to fit correctly. Sometimes it's too low, too high, too gapey, too tight, and I think that this one is just perfect on me. I'm not sure if it's the same for others, but I know that this one fits me really, really well. I didn't have to fiddle with it or modify it in any way, and it just sits really nicely. And I love this dress. I love the drape of the skirt. The circle skirt isn't too big or too small, and it's just gorgeous, and I can wear it layered with tights and a cardigan or just by itself, and it's perfect. So I definitely recommend this one as a wardrobe staple, especially for spring, but also for many other seasons. So the next combination is for warmer weather, and it is this bias cut skirt with a square neck sleeveless top. And the skirt is the Seamwork Desi skirt that I made in this pebbly textured yellow viscose that I bought in Japan back in 2019. And I really love the shape of the skirt. I think that the bias cut drapes really well around the hips without being too tight or clingy. And I love the way that it flares out at the knees. I think it's really beautiful. And then when you're walking or moving around, it sort of drapes really beautifully. But I had an issue with this one, or two issues really, and I haven't really been reaching for it in the past 2 years since I've made it. And it's because it was both slightly transparent and clingy, so it would show everything I was wearing underneath, so my underwear lines, but also if I tucked a top into it, and then it was, yeah, kind of transparent. So I fixed it with two garments. I recently purchased these biker shorts in a nude color, so nude as in close to my skin tone, and then I wear it with this half slip that I purchased almost 10 years ago that is really, really useful in my wardrobe and that prevents static cling as well. And with both of them on, I'm able to smooth down any clothes underneath the skirt so that there are no lines, and then also prevent transparency. And so I think that I will be able to wear this skirt a lot more often, and I think it pairs really well with this top, which is the same top that I'm wearing today. It is the Ose Patterns Brené top in this viscose polyester blend fabric that has a slight jacquard finish to it. I love this top. I made this right before summer vacation, I think 2 years ago, and I've been wearing it so much. It's so versatile in my wardrobe. I love the square neckline and the asymmetrical collar detail. I think that the placement of the neckline is really beautiful and shows off the collarbones really well, and it's not too low and not too high, and I just love it. And I like that the wide straps hide bra straps as well, so it's really practical to wear and just very versatile. And so I highly recommend this one, and I think that these two would go together really well. The last combination is one of my favorites, and it's something that I've even worn out to the ballet or even to a friend's afternoon garden party wedding 2 years ago in May, and it is just gorgeous, and I'm excited to share it with you. And it is this bias cut wrap skirt with a V-neck camisole and a lace effect cardigan over it. The bias cut wrap skirt is the Ose Patterns Kia skirt that I made in this heavyweight viscose in this sort of grayish mauve color, and I love this skirt. This is one of my favorite pieces in my wardrobe. For the beautiful drape and for the color of this fabric, I think that this is also a perfect pattern and fabric pairing that happens usually not very often, but luckily I have two in this video. The construction of this skirt is especially interesting and I think clever because it has a concealed pleat in the front that creates the drape of the wrap in the front part of the skirt. And so that means that no matter how much wind there is the day you're wearing it or how you move, there's no gaping and it won't gape open and expose you. And so that's really practical for wearing and it's just really comfortable. And Ose Patterns is a French pattern maker, but all of the patterns are available in English as well, so definitely don't hesitate to check them out. And the top is the True Bias Ogden cami that I made in a cotton poplin rather than a more drapey fabric that's recommended by the pattern. And those are recommended for a reason because the Ogden cami contains a lot of extra drape and movement in the pattern pieces. And so in a cotton, it just sort of sat and bulked and sort of poofed up at the waist. And so I added darts to it to sort of contain the poof. And I think it works pretty well. And I love this fabric. It's a really beautiful sort of black and purpley fabric. And then I like to pair it with this Jenna cardigan, which is the same as what I'm wearing today and that I talked about before, that I made in the waist length version with the V-neck and with this really cool sort of lace effect knit fabric that I found a long time ago in black. And I really love wearing this one. It sort of adds the perfect amount of texture to a lot of the outfits that I'm wearing. And paired together, all three, I find it very elegant and perfect for a warm spring night and just so elegant. I'm really excited to wear this one again. The last category is weekend activities or relaxation. And the first outfit that I'd like to share is more for the activities part. And it is this jeans and sweater combo. The jeans are the Helen's Closet Brooks jeans that I made last fall. And I created a whole project diary vlog if you'd like to go check that out. But I've been having a hard time wearing these jeans for two reasons. I think first, the light blue color doesn't really correspond to my fall and winter clothes or for the atmosphere and ambiance. And so I want to try wearing it more in the spring and summer. And also it is a non-stretch jean fabric and pattern. And I haven't worn non-stretch jeans since I was a kid. And I think there's a reason for that, that I gravitate more towards stretch jeans. And it's because with Helen's Closet patterns, for example, I have a 3-size difference between my waist and my hips. My waist is 3 sizes smaller than my hips. And so it's really, really hard to get in and out of. I do a lot of very inelegant wiggling to get in and out of it. And once it's on, it's fine, but it is a little bit tight and not very flexible. And I washed it a few times. I haven't worn it very much for this reason. Maybe I can break it in a little bit more, but I'll have to see. So I want to try wearing it this spring to see if in the end I like it or not. And then I want to try pairing it with this Tabor V-neck sweater. I love this sweater. It's in a thicker cotton knit that I really love. It has sort of a stability that creates volume, and I really love that. And then I love the Tabor V-neck sweater, especially the short sleeve version, and I love the neckline. I think that the chunky V-neck is really beautiful, and then I like that in the back it has sort of a dip, which I find very elegant. And I pair this with all kinds of things in the spring and summer. This is a staple for me that I wear all the time, and so I think it'll go really well with these jeans, and I think that it'll be a perfect weekend activity outfit. And then the very last outfit that I wanted to share with you today is for absolute relaxation. And this is something that I almost live in when I'm at home on the weekends or even when I'm working from home. So, and it is this leggings and stretchy top combination. The leggings are the Helen's Closet Avery leggings that I made in this athletic heather gray knit back in, I think, 2020, when we were all at home. And these are so comfortable. The fabric is super soft and stretchy, and I wear them all the time. And I find the very wide waistband really comfortable. And I especially like layering this underneath sort of pajama pants or other stretchy pants when it's very cold out. These are perfect. And then the top is the silver Edie top in a viscose jersey knit, which is really soft and very drapey. And I love the boat neck neckline and the 3/4 sleeves. I think that it creates an elegant sort of version of what would be a very drapey t-shirt. And I love wearing these two together. I think that the long length of the silver Edie top sort of complements the tightness of the leggings. It doesn't make it too tight and revealing on me. And so I wear these two together all the time for sewing, knitting, reading on the couch, staying in bed, sleeping in. And this is definitely my favorite for a sort of stretchy relaxation outfit. And last but not least, the star of my spring transitional wardrobe is my trench coat. This is the named patterns Isla trench coat that I made back in 2018, and I have worn this coat almost exclusively every spring and fall for the past 6 years, and it is definitely my most important coat that I've ever made in my handmade coat wardrobe. And I love it. I made it in this water-resistant beigey gray or grayish cotton gabardine fabric that I found at Sacré Coupon a long time ago, just serendipitously. I was walking by, it was in an outdoor bin, which was just, oh, so lucky. And I modified the pattern so that the hem would sit just above my knee rather than mid-calf like the pattern is originally designed. And I think if I made it again, I would make it mid-calf because I'm more comfortable with longer hemlines now. But I love this trench coat. It was definitely really hard to make. All of the little bits that make it a trench coat were very difficult to fit in the machine and sew with precision, but it was worth every second of effort. I have worn it so much. It is so important to me. It's starting to look a little bit ratty, especially around the cuffs and the edges where it's gotten a lot of friction, but I love it and I want it to last as long as possible. I think it'll last another year or so, but I am starting to think of making another one. But I have my eye out for similar fabrics and especially similar colors because I think that this color works really well with my wardrobe and my coloring, and I just love it. It goes so well with everything, whether I'm wearing a casual jean and sweater combo or a more formal dress or skirt. It's just perfect. I love it. So there you have it. Those are all 8 handmade outfits and wardrobe staple that I will be wearing this spring. Let me know in the comments what your absolute staples are or your favorite patterns to wear in the spring. I am always looking for new patterns to try out. Right now I'm working on my travel wardrobe for my honeymoon in Japan, which I made a whole video planning. If you'd like to check that out, I'll link it here. But I have less than 3 weeks left and I need to start the swimsuit and I'm very nervous, but also very excited. So I need to get to that, and yeah, that's what I'm working on now. I have linked all of the patterns that I've talked about today, and there are a lot of them in the description below, so don't hesitate to check that out. And I hope you're doing well. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed, and take care. Bye-bye.